Hello children, in this video we will get to know about the various accessibility options given by the computer. Now what is computer accessibility? Computer accessibility refers to the user friendliness of a computer system for all, regardless of their disability. This is mainly a software issue. However, when a combination of hardware and software, it enables the person with a disability or impairment to use a computer. Now, what does it mean? It means computer accessibility feature allow the people having any kind of disability to use it. Okay, it makes the working of the computer system so easier that the people having any kind of problem can use it. Now, what are the different problems that people are facing in using the computer? There are numerous types of impairment that impact computer uses. These include cognitive impairments and learning disabilities such as dyslexia, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, or autism. So, cognitive impairments means the person is not able to recognize the letters. Fine. Then we have visual impairment, such as low vision, complete or partial blindness, and color blindness. The person who is not able to see properly. Hearing impairment, including deafness. The person who is having problem in hearing. Motor or dexterity impairments, such as paralysis, cerebral palsy or carpal tunnel syndrome, and repetitive strain injury. So any kind of injury in the body, right? Or any kind of impairment in the body like paralysis. First, we have accessibility options in Windows OS. So we have different accessibility options in Windows. First, we have the keyboard tab. And in keyboard tab, we have three keys: sticky keys, filter keys, and toggle keys. Now, we will know about their functioning one by one. First, we have the sticky keys. Sticky keys is an accessibility feature to help computer users with physical disabilities, but it is also used by others as a means to reduce repetitive strain. Sticky keys allows the user. Sticky keys allows the user to press and release a modifier key such as Shift, Control, Alt, or the window keys, and have it remain active until any other key is pressed. So the people who are having some problem in their fingers or in their hand, they can use sticky keys. Sticky keys allows to press the modifier keys such as Shift, Control, Alt. And these keys will remain active until any other key is pressed, right? Just take an example. If you want to select the text, so you can press the control key, and then you can release the control key, and after that, when you will press A, the document will be selected. So how you can activate the sticky keys, that I'm going to show you. So here we will open the control panel, and in the control panel click on Ace of Access Center, right? In this we have option make the keyboard easier to use. Click on this. Okay, now here we have turn on the sticky keys. So you have to click on this, right? And then click on apply, and then click on OK, right? In this way, you have turned on the sticky keys. So here I am clicking the Alt key, and then after that I am releasing it, and then I'll press A. Sorry, Control key, and then I'll release the control key, and then I'll press A. Now you can see I pressed the control key, and then I released it, and after that I pressed the A, control A. Now the my text is selected. Fine. So this is the function of your sticky keys. Now we will go to the next key. Now we have filter keys. It is an accessibility function that tells the keyboard to ignore brief or repeated keystrokes, making typing easier for the people with hand tremors. This key allows you to press any letter, any number, a number of times, but it will appear only once on the screen. Right, if I'm pressing, just take one example, if I'm pressing A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times, but it will appear only one time on the screen. Right, so how you will activate the filter key? Again, click on make the keyboard easier to use in the control panel, and here you have the option of filter keys. Click on turn on filter keys, right? And then again apply and then okay. Fine. Now here if I am writing any character, if I am pressing any character, you can see I am pressing D again and again, but it is coming only once, right? It is not coming the number of times, it is coming only once because of filter key, right? Next we have toggle keys. It is an accessibility function which is designed for people who have vision impairment or cognitive disabilities. When toggle key is turned on, computer emits sound cues when the locking keys caps lock, num lock or scroll lock are pressed. Okay, so the people who are having problem in the vision, for these peoples we have toggle keys. So what is the function of toggle key? It will emit the sound cues when we will press the locking keys like caps lock, num lock or scroll lock, right? A high sound is emitted when the keys are switched on, or a low sound is emitted when they are switched off, right? So when the keys are switched on, high sound is emitted, and when the keys are switched off, low sound is emitted. Fine, so we will do it practically. Again, make the keyboard easier to use. Turn on the toggle key. Right? Okay. So here a tone when you press caps lock, num lock and scroll lock, right? Apply and then okay. So if I'll press the caps lock, okay, this is when I switch on the key, and this is when I switch off the caps lock key. Then num lock on, then this is scroll lock, right? So these sounds are coming because of toggle key. Fine. Okay. Now we will move to the next option. Sound tab, right? So in sound tab we will get the options related to the sound. So it is having two options: sound, sentry and show sounds, right? Now what is sound sentry? Sound sentry is designed to help users with auditory impairment. Sound sentry generates visual warnings such as blinking title bar or a flashing border whenever the computer generates a sound. So sound sentry is the option which is given for the people who have problem in hearing, right? So instead of hearing the sound, they can see the messages, right? So sound sanitary generates visual warnings such as blinking title bar or a flashing border whenever computer generates a sound. Okay, instead of the sound, they will get the blinking title bar or flashing border, right? So how you can select the sound sanitary tab? Again, we will go to the control panel, right? Okay, now we have the option use text or visual alternatives for sound, right? In this, you will get the option turn on visual notification for sound. So instead of sound, you will get the notification. You have to click on this, right? And then apply and then click on OK, right? So from here, you can choose flash active caption bar, flash active window, flash desktop, right? So instead of the sound, you will get these, fine? Okay, next we have show sounds, right? Show sounds instruct applications that convey information by sound to also provide information visually through text captions or informative icons. So the application which convey the information by sounds, they instead of the sound, what they will do, they will provide the information visually through the text captions or through the text or through the informative icons or through the different icons, through the different pictures, right? How you will activate this? Again, control panel. Here you have an option, turn on text caption for spoken dialogues, right? So whatever you are speaking, for that you will get the text, right? Fine. So you have to select this and then click on apply and then okay. Next we have the display tab. And in display tab, we have two options, high contrast and cursor option. High contrast is an accessibility feature to assist people with vision impairment. You can change the size and the color of fonts and the background for ease of viewing. So the people who are having problem in the vision, they can use high contrast feature. They can change the size and the color of the fonts and the background for their purpose, right? So how you will activate this? Again, we will go to the control panel, right? In control panel, we have the option make the computer easier to see, right? Fine. Now here you can click on turn on or off high contrast. This turn on or off high contrast and then click on the apply and then contrast, right? So in this way you can adjust the contrast of your system, fine? It is having two options, display a warning message when turning a setting on, make a sound when turning a setting on or off. Turn on or off high contrast when left alt plus left shift plus print screen is pressed, right? So in this way, you can change the contrast of your system. Then we have cursor option. Cursor option is also an accessibility feature that assists people with vision impairment by changing the blink rate and the width of the cursor. Okay, the people, those who are having a problem in the vision, they can change the blink rate and the width of the cursor. How? Here you can see we have an option, set the thickness of the blinking cursor and the different numbers are given to us. So if I'm clicking on the 15, you can see the change of the cursor has been, the size of the cursor has been changed, right? So in this way, you can change the thickness of the cursor, fine? Next, we have the mouse tab, mouse keys. Mouse keys is an accessibility feature that assists people who have difficulty with the mouse. This option uses the keyboard, especially numeric keypad, as a pointing device instead of a mouse. So those who are having problem in using the mouse, they can use the keyboard as a mouse, right? So how you can activate it? Again, we will go to the control panel. And here we have an option, make the mouse easier to use, right? And you have to click on turn on the mouse key, right? Use the numeric keypad to move the mouse around the screen. So when you will click on turn on mouse keys, you can use the keypad to move like a mouse on the screen. Fine. So basically this is used with the desktop where you have two numeric keypads, right? Then we have journal tab, serial keys. Serial keys is an accessibility feature that assists people that have difficulty using a keyboard or a mouse or both. They can use special devices such as SIP, PUF and breast switches to provide input to the computer through serial ports, right? So in this case, serial key is an accessibility feature that assists people that have difficulty. Those who are having difficulty in using both keyboard and the mouse, they can use a special input device, right? In that input device, they can give their input by different things, like they can sip or they can puff, right? Sip like this. The sip, as we sip the water, puff means when you blow the air from your mouth, and breath switches, right? So here we are using the mouth to give the signals, right? To provide input to the computer through serial ports. So these devices are attached to the serial ports, and we can use our mouth and we can give the signals like sip, puff and breath switches, right? To provide input to the through the serial ports. So this is all about the different accessibility options that we can use in the computer.